Welcome back to Big Brother's Big Mouth. Manchester, so much to answer for. It's Terry Christian. And oh, what's occurring? It's Scott Mills.
Oh.
And she's like one of those clever people, you know, you see on a bus, like reading a book, thinking that they're better than you because they've got GCSEs and an indoor loo. It's Susan Calman! And of course, our sexy audience. Right. Everybody knows my boy Westwood. As much mad love for Big Brother as he has for UK hip hop, this is a heavy clip.
This is Big Brother speaking. Please come to the diary room. Diary room. Diary room. We're riding big with Westwood's clip of the week. Let's go in.
We referred to why we had been falling out, why we'd had so many arguments.
Go hard or go home.
Westwood!
Westwood! So, the Big Brother boy baby's had his toys taken away. He's been dumped on the naughty step. Please give it up for Jovan!
I was just gonna say, how tough did you actually find it in there?
It was hard. It was a lot easier than I thought it would be, though. I found it harder coming out. And
yes, because you're cocooned in there.
Yeah, and then walking past people like, boo.
Were you scared of coming out?
Yeah. Okay. Very scared.
Also, did you ever, be honest, stir things on purpose?
Of course I can be honest. I knew, especially what happened with Shabby, I knew she was going to kick off. But...
Hang on, let him finish.
I knew that was obviously not good. She wasn't going to just keep that quiet. But I honestly didn't do that in, you know, just to make her angry.
Well, I'd have done it for fun.
And owned up to that.
Oh yeah.
Susan, what are people on?
Well, there's a lot of support for you, Jovan, on the interweb. There's a lot of support. You've got a lovely statement. Liddell says, "I'm so sad Jovan's been evicted. He was funny, cute, just like a playful puppy." Jovan was the most interesting out of all of those four noms. So you've got a lot of support out there as well. Some people have pointed out as well. Kraken Toko said, "One minute he was on one side, then another. It just got too much. Glad he's gone." So I think people thought maybe you kind of switched sides occasionally, I think.
Between whom?
Well, just sort of anybody. So, I mean, you were kind of everybody's friends and people would tell you stuff, really, and I think that's... they felt that you potentially used what you learned from various people to go round.
I think I just had a bit of a big mouth. Said things I shouldn't have said.
That was great.
OK, who wants to ask Jovan a question? I'm going to go up here.
Get it in context.
Jovan, when you were in the house, you really, really wound me up, and you come out and you just look like a slap puppy and I just want to hug you. And when you're in it, I really, really, really felt that it was a bit of a waste and somebody could have been in there who really, really wanted to be in there. Did you seriously
want
to
be
in there? I think you're really brave going in, but did you seriously, seriously want to be in there?
Generally, yes. But, I mean, until you've actually been in there, it's very, very, very hard.
What made you apply for it?
I've watched all of them and I thought, wow, that looks like so much fun. I want to do that. Then one particular day, just sent me down, 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 and I couldn't get out of it for a couple of days.
Now you've come out and you've heard what people are saying and your fellow housemates have said, would you have done anything differently?
I'd have sucked it up a little bit and just had fun, as opposed to, as some people said, being miserable for a couple of days.
Hug him, Scott. So, it's the moment we've all... thank you. It's the moment we've all been waiting for, guys. He's gorgeous. He's sexy. He's a chest of drawers. Give it up for the Tree of Temptation!
I'm all right. How are you?
So I see you've picked yourself a nice couple of girls up along en route.
Yeah, they're pretty fit.
Really fit. So how are you feeling?
Oh, I'm glad to be out of that house.
Oh, yeah, it's nice to have you down here.
That bathroom absolutely reeks.
Oh, really?
Absolutely reeks, but so does that bloody audience as well.
Oh, sorry. Listen, we've got so many questions for you. I'm going to start off with Scott. Scott, what would you like to ask the Tree of Temptation?
I'd like to know, seeing as you obviously see everything and we don't see... we see a lot, but we don't see absolutely everything on the TV show. What have you seen that we maybe haven't seen? So, any goss that you've got?
Well, that's a stupid, dumb question, isn't it? It's absolutely dumb, and I hate you, Scott Mills, by the way. Absolutely hate you. If you ask me another dumb question like that, I'm going to... chuck the full wrath of the Tree of Temptation right in your face.
I've always wanted to be abused by the tree. Brilliant.
Yay! Yeah! And, Terry?
I'm scared now.
Yeah, go on, ask
well,
it, no, be
I was
brave.
Gonna say, was there anything you saw in there that gave you a bit of extra wood, if you know what I mean?
What kind of question is that? Are you some kind of pervert?
Yeah.
Don't mess
Someone
with me, Christian.
Someone who likes to, like, rummage through your drawers.
You're a gobby mank idiot. Now, shut up.
Susan, do you want to ask anything?
Yes, first of all, I'd like to say I love your work, Tree, with Scabby.
Oh, shut
I
up. Think you're lovely.
When he went into the house, Jovan said he had a big one. Tree, you've been in the bathroom with him. How big is his cock?
What kind of show is this, Davina? Is this some kind of pervy show? I didn't come up here to
yes,
talk about
well,
cocks.
Yes, well, sometimes it does disintegrate into that. Has anybody got a question they'd like to
it's
ask
It's not
Tree?
About cocks.
Tree? Tree?
Yes?
Can you just go and piss off?
Davina,
No, he wants you to say piss off.
I'm not a performing monkey.
Davina.
I'd like to know, Tree...
What?
Don't take that tone.
I'll take whatever tone I want. Just spit out the question, hurry
up. OK, just hold on. When Big Brother finishes, will you be flat-packing yourself and taking yourself back off to IKEA where you belong?
Oh, you're going down.
I don't like you at all. I don't like you at all. After the show, I just want to be left alone. I might retire, maybe go to a nursing home or something, somewhere where I'm not bothered by bloody housemates.
I think the Tree deserves his own show,
yes.
Frankly.
Yes.
Yes. Susan, what would anybody like to
we've
ask?
We've got a question here from a viewer. iDanny2010 says, Tree of Temptation, you are a coward. Give them something hard or else I will personally come down to the house and axe you myself.
That's fighting talk. I dare him to come down to Boreham Wood and say that to my face.
Well. And Tree, let's give you the final word. Let's hear your final word on all the housemates. Come on, what about Ben?
Shit.
Kiva?
Shit.
Corin?
Shit.
Dave?
Shit.
Oh, Iffy?
Shit.
John James?
Dumb shit.
Josie? Hey.
Gobshite.
Jovan?
Very shit.
Mario.
Nob.
Nathan.
Who?
Stephen. Steve, I mean.
Shit.
Shabby.
Shit.
Sunshine.
Irritant.
Oh, dear. Well, listen, Tree.
What?
Thanks. Thanks very much for being part of the show. Big round of applause for Tree. Thanks, everyone. Can you stick around for the rest of the show?
Yeah, I haven't got much choice, have I?
All right, listen, we're going to move on, talk crime. Listen, it's bad everywhere. Bad people. Bad people doing bad things. It's getting worse. But there are a few good guys out there. I'm talking about the law. The rozzers. The filth. The fuzz. The crazy popo. People like Cagney and Lacey. People like Rosemary and Thyme. And now there's Jones and Tyler. Strap yourselves on for this.
That's the sound that I'm police. That's the sound that I'm police. That's the sound that I'm police.
Yes.
Yeah, you make me sick.
Good to know. Men like you will be off the streets.
We're really cracking down at the moment, particularly on straight women who pretend to be lesbians to turn on men. It's a big problem for us at the moment. You're looking at 3 to 5 years behind bars.
Lima Papa receiving.
Right, we've just received reports of somebody falsely impersonating a lesbian to get onto a TV show. It's the picture of the suspect. Nice try, but there's no fooling me with that haircut. Lesbian police.
Right, OK.
We have reason to believe you are inhabiting a female who has wrongly claimed to be a lesbian.
Right, I don't know what's going
don't
on
Don't come
here.
Any closer.
I'm afraid you're going to have to nick off.
If you'll just let us speak to Kaiwi Wumi.
Who's that?